The objective of this video is to make a clear differentiation between the anesthesia device and the ICU mechanical ventilators. One main difference between an anesthesia device and an ICU mechanical ventilator is the leakage compensation. Generally speaking, in the anesthesia devices, we don't have the capacity to compensate such leakages. The inability of the anesthesia device to compensate leakages has to be considered by the user, especially when volume control ventilation modes are used. Depending on the module of the anesthesia device used, PEEP level will not be maintained because of the inability of the anesthesia device to compensate leakages. In the event of a fresh gas flow deficit situation, meaning that the leakage is higher than the set fresh gas flow, this might impair the mechanical ventilation, meaning that an urgent action by the user is required, either by reducing the leakage or by increasing the fresh gas flow. In the case of an emergency situation, when we have a large leakage, we have the alternative to disconnect the manual breathing bag from the breathing system. This will allow the ambient air to enter the breathing system, but we have to consider that the percentage of oxygen in the breathing system will be between the set percentage of oxygen in the fresh gas flow and the 21% of the ambient air. Another important difference to highlight is that because of the intended use of the anesthesia device in the operating room, we do not have available a locking function. So there is no way to restrict the access to the configuration of the device. Another important difference to highlight is the alarm management in the anesthesia device. Please keep in mind that once the condition triggering the alarm in the first place is not there anymore, the message in the display will be deleted. Ideally, we have to remember that the user has to be next or close to the anesthesia device all the time. If that is not the case, remember you can always check on the alarms going into the logbook and verifying if something occurred in the absence of the user. Another important difference is that the alarms occurring on the anesthesia device will not be automatically transferred to the alarm central station. Another important difference between anesthesia devices and mechanical ventilator is that the alarm messages are not displayed and they are not recorded once you have gone into a standby. Another important difference to highlight between anesthesia devices and ICU mechanical ventilator is the performance of the self-test. Here we have to remember that in normal operation, we have to run the self-test on the anesthesia device every 24 hours. In the use of the anesthesia device for long-term ventilation, we recommend a minimum of 72 hours between test and test. Remember that prior to the running of the self-test on the anesthesia device, you have to disconnect the patient from the respiratory breathing system. During this time, either you can manually ventilate the patient using an external manual breathing bag, or you can use any available ventilator. We will provide additional video content going into details on how to perform the self-test and the leakage test. Additionally to that, we will cover the differences between the ventilation modes.